Praise the Lord, saints. Truly, it is an honor and a privilege to be standing before you today in the presence of God. I thank God for his goodness. I thank him for his mercy. I thank God for so many things that he has done for me and my family during this time that we're facing today. I look at the lesson today, and the title of our lesson today that the author has given us is God Will Supply. And I think this is a very appropriate lesson, given that the time and circumstances that we're living today. That title, God Will Supply. And before I even got into the lesson, just reading the title alone, God Will Supply, brought so many things into my mind. I thought about God being a provider, God being a healer, God being a deliverer. Truly, when that title says God will supply whatever we need. And I just got that from the title, just thinking about the goodness of the Lord and all the benefits that he has provided for myself and my family. I thank God for the benefits that he has provided for the church. So as I get into the lesson, again, the title is God Will Supply. The focus thought of our lesson reads, God takes care of his people. Think about that. God takes care of his people. Our focus verse is coming from the book of 1 Kings chapter 17 and verse 16. Our lesson text is coming from the book of 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 1 through 4. In verse 8 through 16. The lesson text, 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 1 through 4, and I will go down to verse 8 and read through verse 16. And Elisha, the Tishbite, who was of the inhabitants of Gilead, said unto Ahab, as the Lord God of Israel liveth, before whom I stand, there should not be dew nor rain these days, but according to my word. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, get thee hence, and turn thee eastward, and hide thyself by the brook of Cherith, that is before Jordan. And it shall be that thou shalt drink of the brook, and I have commanded the ravens to feed thee there. Beginning at verse number 8. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, arise, get thee to Zephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. So he rose and went to Zephath, and when he came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there gathering of sticks. And he called to her and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink. And as she was going to fetch it, he called to her and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thy hand. And she said, as the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake, but a handful of meal in a barrel, and a little oil in a cruse. And behold, I am gathering two sticks, that I may go in and dress it for me and my son, that we may eat it and die. And Elijah said unto her, fear not, go and do as thou hast said, but make me thereof a little cake first, and bring it to me, and after make thee and for thy son. For thus saith the Lord God of Israel, the barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail, until the day that the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth. And she went and did according to the saying of Elijah, and she and he and her house did eat many days. And the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord, which he spake by Elijah. As I said, I thank God at the beginning of this lesson that read, God will supply. And the focus verse, God takes care of his people. And I know that is a true statement. I can't tell you how many times God has watched over me, guided me, and protected me all throughout my life. But I thank God, as I thought about this, just as a parent loves his or her child, and that parent would do anything they can to protect that child, nourish that child, and make sure that that child has what it needs to grow and develop. And God does the same thing for us. God is a loving parent. We call him our Heavenly Father. God loves us. And as a parent and as a loving God, God will supply our needs. Now, a natural parent does everything they can to support their children. But as a natural parent, I know in my household, I didn't give my children everything they wanted because I realized that everything they wanted wasn't always good for them. And God does the same thing for each and every one. As the scripture says, God will supply our needs. And there are times God will give us things that we want and things that we desire. But God is not going to give us everything that we want, because God realizes, just like we do as a parent, that everything we want is not necessarily good for us. And he knows that, and as a parent, he's not trying to withhold anything from us, but God realizes that that's not good for you. And God knows best. Just like the old cliche, fathers knows best, God knows best. So I thank God as we get into the Word of God and how we begin to look at the life of Elijah. After Elijah had spoke to Ahab about the rain, God commanded him to move. And as he moved to a brook, he said, go there. Elijah didn't question. He was obedient. He obeyed, and he left. And God said, when you get there, you have water to drink. And I like this verse. He said, I have commanded. Now, if there was any doubt in your mind about the power of God, God has all power, all supernatural power. Not only can he command the wind, the rain, the waters, the rivers, but he said, I have commanded the ravens to bring you something to eat. And as I looked at this lesson, I began to think about it in my mind. I was picturing a raven and thinking, well, that's kind of a small bird right there to be bringing some food. And then I looked this up, that the common raven stands about 2 feet tall. And I said, wow, 2 feet tall? That's a pretty good sized bird right there that has a wingspan of 4 feet. That means that from tip of one wing to the other end, that's a wingspan of 4 feet. Standing 2 feet tall. And so with a bird with that type of capacity, I realized that yes, it can sustain Elijah and bring him food out there in the wilderness where he remained. Because God has all power. And so as I look at the Word of God, God provided for Elijah. You know, God is not going to tell us to go somewhere. He's not going to tell us to do something and yet don't meet the needs that we're looking for. I remember in the scripture when God called Barnabas to go out and Paul, the scripture said that the elders of the church laid hands on them. But God called them. He knew the task that was set before them. And he knew that they were going to face many trials and tribulations on that journey. And to prepare them, they laid hands and prayed, and God knew with his power and the power of the Holy Ghost that he would sustain them and provide the needs that they're looking for. And so as we look at Elijah, we look at the power of God and what God did for him, God can do the same thing for us. When he went down there and he met the widow woman, if you look at your scripture, and I'm going back into verse number 9, 1 Kings chapter 17 and verse 9. He says, arise and get to Zarephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. And he said, behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. So before Elijah even met the widow woman, God had already placed the tools necessary in his life for him to survive and to be sustained and fed. But not only him, but the widow woman and her son as well. God is a good God. He's an awesome God. And I think about so many times in our lifetime, if God has called you into a ministry, if God has called you to do a work for him, God will supply the needs, the tools that's necessary to help you accomplish that mission. As the lesson says, God will supply. The author of our lesson said a few words that I want to quote and share with you. God knows every need and is faithful to provide. Sometimes he asks us to do and go into a situation that requires things we do not have, but he knows those needs before we even ask. It's part of his plan. God knows what we need. God knows to sustain the life of man and to include woman. We need food, shelter, and clothing. And many times, we're living in a time now that I hear so many people talk about, have you gone to the store and seen the price of meat? My goodness, the price of meat is just skyrocketing. God knows this. But one thing I realize is that in the house of God, God is not going to allow his people to perish. God will provide. And many times God provides for us through the means of the saints of God. I remember Pastor James Anderson talking about when you could go to the store and you couldn't find toilet paper in the store. And I remember Pastor Anderson said, we have supplies here that we can help you. If there's any member of God that is in lack or in need, come to the church. And Pastor says, if it's food, if it's meat, or as Pastor James said, if there's things you're looking for to help you to sustain, the church is here. You see, the church is an acting member, a part of God's will. Many times we have too much pride to ask for help. I know I do. When I thought about this, there are times when I'm doing things at home and my wife says, Calvin, can I help you? I say, no, I got it. And sometimes my pride or my ego gets in the way and I feel like that as a man, I can do it and I can do it all by myself. But I have to realize that God gave me a helpmeet. Now that helpmeet is not benefiting me if I leave it sitting on the sideline. But sometimes I got to say, wife, I need help. Because she has offered her assistance, I've got to say, I need help. And God will provide for the saints of God. God will provide for his people. And sometimes, as I said, a means of providing for the people of God is to ask the church. Asking the pastor of the church, Pastor, I need help. Can the church help me? The scripture says, even in our lesson, I'm going back to the lesson, God will supply. But God's not always going to supply our needs the way we think he's going to do it. And there are many times that God utilizes the church to supply the needs of the people. In Philippians chapter 4 in verse 19, it reads, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Jesus Christ. My God shall supply what? All of your needs. As I said earlier, God will give us some of our wants and God will give us some of our desires. But the scripture says he will supply our needs. What do we need today? We need salvation. Above anything else, we need God in our life. We need Jesus to come into our life. We need to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost, and be obedient to the word of God. But we need salvation. We need food, we need shelter, we need clothing. And realize, saints, that God knows these things right here. Jesus Christ knows what we need in order to survive. He knows what we need in order to sustain our life. God will supply. When we go back and look at the Word of God, it tells us to put our trust in Him. Sometimes it's hard for man to trust in anything, particularly another individual, because we realize that individuals will let us down. Mankind will let us down. But Jesus Christ will never let us down. But the scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Think about that. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. When we learn to seek God, when we learn to put God first in our life, God will bless us. But we got to realize and say, Lord, I can't go before God with a wish list and saying, Lord, I want this, I want this, I want this. And yes, as I said, we have needs. But in the midst of everything, yes, we must learn to put God first. God requires us to put Him first. When we go out and we do different tasks, we run out. We say we're running errands out there. But do what we think about before I leave the house, Lord, help me today. Before I get in that car, Lord, help me. Even if I'm going to the grocery store, to the supermarket, or going wherever, before I leave the house, or before I turn the ignition, Lord, help me. It may sound simple, but it's putting God first in everything we do. When I go to work in the morning, when I go to bed at night, the first thing I want to do is say, Lord, I thank you for waking me up this morning. When I go to bed at night, Lord, I thank you for keeping me safe as I went through the day. We have to learn to put God first in our life. We have to learn to seek God in everything that we do. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. What things are we talking about? God knows what we need. He knows what we need in our life. But we have to learn to seek God. And also seeking God, we have to learn to be obedient to God. We have to learn to do the things that God wants us to do. We have to learn to be what God wants us to be. We have to learn to be an ambassador for God. We have to learn to be a witness for God. But the scripture says to us to seek ye first the kingdom of God. We have to learn this right here. I have to learn this, that God will supply my needs. But at the same time, I have to learn to put God first. Because as I look at the scripture and the focused thought that the author gave us, he said, God takes care. Think about that. Think about that. God takes care of His people. God takes care of His people. I thank God for His goodness and His mercy. And I'm realizing as we go through these turbulent times today, if we go to the store and there's a run on toilet paper, if there's a run that we feel like hamburger prices are going up, pork prices are going up, beef prices going up, that's the world. But as children of God, God knows what we need to help us to sustain life. And if we just learn to put our trust in Him, not putting our trust in man, and it's good to have neighbors, it's good to have friends, but if we would learn to put our trust in God, and if we would learn to seek God first, God will not let us down. Because as the scripture states, and I stand by His word, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Our lesson tells us in the book of 1 Kings that God commanded the ravens, think about this, God commanded the ravens to feed Elisha. God commanded the widow woman to sustain and support him. Even before he met her, God was already working. And God is already working in our life today. God knows what we need. God's going to protect us. God's going to keep us safe. As we go through turbulent times today, we have to remember this. Put our trust in God. And God will not let us down. Man may let us down. And I should say, man sometimes will let us down. But if we learn to trust God, God will keep us safe. As we dealing with the coronavirus, and as people want to say the new norms of life, or whatever case that comes out, here's the scripture. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. And if we do that, God will supply the needs that we have in our life. If it's toilet paper, if it's food, if it's clothing, if it's shelter, whatever it is we need, let's put God first and let God supply the needs of our life. Amen.